Hi, it's Miss Julie. I'm coming to you from my dining room to give everyone an update on Quail Watch 2020. At this point, we are halfway through our 23-day incubation period. I want to say thank you to anyone that attended our Hatching Northern Bobwhite Quail program on April 17th, given by Ranger Eric Powers from the Center for Environmental Exploration and Discovery. During the program, he gave an introduction to hatching quail and his quail versus tick study. For those of you that didn't, I'm just going to give you a little background as to why we even chose to hatch northern bobwhite quail. Many years ago on Long Island, the quail population was high and the tick population was low, and that's because quail eat ticks. Due to a bunch of different human decisions, the quail population dropped and the tick population rose, which means that humans contracted more tick-borne illnesses. So our hope is that we can hatch these quail. Ranger Powers will release them into the wild through his quail versus tick study, and that we can help set things back into balance. So let's take a peek at the incubator and give our eggs a turn. So here are 28 eggs. As you can see, I've marked the eggs with a circle and a dot, so that when I turn them, I'll know that I've turned every single one of them if the marking is face down. I've been turning these about 8 times a day, although I think it would be acceptable to turn them 2 to 4 times a day, but I just want to give them as much of a chance to hatch as I can. I have the eggs sitting here on this metal grate. And beneath the metal grate is a plastic trough that's filled with water. And the water is to keep the humidity constant inside this incubator. During the second week, I added more water to raise the humidity level. And next week, our last week of incubation, I will add more water to raise it even higher, so that our eggs can hatch on the 23rd day. And that's our update on Quail Watch 2020. If you have any questions about this quail hatching adventure, please email them to contact us at bbplibrary.org, and I will do my best to answer those questions in our next update. Bye!